I'm 6 o'clock, we call the meeting of October the 17th, Rankin City Council meeting to order. We welcome everyone to our meeting tonight, and if I could, ask everyone if they would to silence their cell phone and stand and join in the pledge of flag, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much. Okay, mayor's comments, reference the 11-day fire event. We had a great 11-day of the Country Fire Festival. Thank all of the staff and the people involved that made it happen. And thank our law enforcement officers, Chief Tatum and his staff, for a great security provided. It's a family event, and it was a great fire this year, so we're very pleased that it's over, but we're always happy to see it come back next year, but when it's over, we're glad to see it gone for a little while. Okay, I assume everybody got their agenda. Is any corrections to the agenda? I have one request. That item 7 on the new business, administrative item. Under old business, item 3, postpone that until the next meeting.
I make a motion.
Don't have a second there. Please vote. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Any other corrections to the agenda? I hear it. Motion to be approved as presented.
So moved.
Second.
Please vote. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, the minutes of the regular council meeting, September the 19th. I assume everybody got a copy. Of the minutes, if no correction, chair will entertain a motion.
So moved.
Have a second?
Second to move.
Please vote. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item 5, we have a couple of proclamations here that I'll read and ask the representatives from each one to come up, please. The first one is the Poppy Day, American Legion Ladies Auxiliary. Y'all would come to the podium and then we'll read the come on around and we'll read the proclamation. Face that and we'll present you with the proclamation if you would. We want to get a camera for all of it, a picture of all of it. Poppy Day Proclamation, American Legion Auxiliary. Whereas America is the land of freedom, preserved and protected willingly and freely by citizen soldiers. Whereas millions who have answered the call to arms have died on the field of battle. And whereas a nation at peace must be reminded of Christ's war and the debt owed to those who have died in the wars. And whereas the red poppy has been designated as a symbol of sacrifice of lives in all wars. Whereas the American Legion Auxiliary has pledged to remind America annually of this day through this distribution of the memorial flower. Therefore, H. Ward Gravitt is mayor and the Cumming City Council of the City of Cumming do hereby proclaim November the 11th, 2017 as Poppy Day in the Cumming, Georgia, and ask that all citizens pay tribute to those who have made the ultimate sacrifice in the name of freedom by wearing the memorial poppy on this day. Signed by myself as mayor of the city of Cumming. All of the council would come around for a ceremony and would be presented by Poppy M. These ladies accept this proclamation. Emily.
Function.
Okay, one more camera, just stay there. Ready?
Again, thank y'all so much for what you do this given me. Okay, we have a proclamation for Domestic Violence Awareness Month for Forsyth Family Haven. Y'all would come on up and I'll read the proclamation and we'll present to you all.
Sure.
Mr. Mayor and Councilman, we would just like to express our sincere gratitude. I am the Secretary on the Board of Directors, Holly Barrett, and this is Brady Densmore. She's the President on the Board of Directors. And we would just like to announce some things that we believe best for our community.
Thank you. Forsyth County Family Haven has served this community for 28 years. We provide emergency shelter and transitional housing, 24/7 crisis line, as well as an array of outreach services. Services provided include individual, family group counseling, therapy, support groups, domestic violence and parenting education, legal advocacy, safe dates project, and community outreach and education. We also have a thrift shop. Family Haven, I'd like to share with you some of their numbers. 207. This is the number of women and children served by Family Haven's emergency shelter. Families stay an average of 78 days and receive food, clothing, case management, life skills, access to medical care, and a safety plan. 4,622, the number of domestic violence victims served by Family Haven's crisis line, legal advocacy services, community support groups, and other outreach services. 86% of every dollar donated goes directly to serving victims and families. Only 14% goes to the overhead. $4,200 is the average cost to shelter one individual or child based on a 70-day shelter stay. 45, the number of shelter and transitional housing beds available. Family Haven works diligently to find outside resources and shelter when in capacity for victims and families in danger. 0, the amount paid by victims for services provided by Family Haven. We believe that victims and their families should focus on healing, developing a sustainable safety plan, and becoming self-sufficient.
Once again, thank you very much.
Thank you so much. If y'all would just stand there, we'll read the proclamation. Proclamation recognizing Domestic Violence Awareness Month. Whereas every 15 seconds a woman is battered in the United States by her husband or partner. And whereas every day for battered women, four battered women are killed in the United States. In homes where spousal abuse occurs, children are abused at a rate of 1,500% higher than the national average. Approximately 5,390 women and children sought safe shelter and other services from Georgia domestic violence shelters during the past year. And whereas approximately 4,336 victims and their dependent children of Forsyth County received crisis intervention and advocacy services from Forsyth County Family Haven, during the past year. And whereas violence against women and children continues to become more prevalent as a social problem. And whereas the crime of domestic violence violates an individual's privacy, dignity, security, and humanity due to the systematic use of physical, emotional, sexual, physiological, and economic control and our abuse. Now therefore, H4 Gravitt is mayor of the city Cumming, Cumming City Council, do hereby set my hand on this 17th day of October 2017 to declare October 2017 as Domestic Violence Awareness Month in the city of Cumming, Georgia, and urge all residents to actively participate in scheduled activities and progress programs sponsored by Forsyth County Family Haven Incorporated and other awareness organizations during this month. Signed by me as mayor of the city of Cumming, Calwood, Cumming. Okay, moving right on to item 6 under old business. Item 1, Marketplace Cummins Committee Report. We have done some work in reference to the request at our last meeting in reference to the service fees that were charged to Marketplace Cummins. And some of the work that we did, we determined with the engineers cost of replacing signage, street signage, resurfacing, restriping, those in particular, and found out the cost, whenever that become necessary, it may be 20 years down the road before the road might need any maintenance and before any signage might be replaced, according to the engineers. But the committee has done a lot of work on it. And Chuck Wells, councilman, he's got a recommendation here from the committee to the board for the request tonight. So, Chuck.
Thank you, Mayor. Based on the comments at last month's meeting, the public participation section, and then as a member of the committee, the mayor and I met with some of the homeowners this past Thursday here at City Hall. And we left the meeting and have some suggestions and recommendations I'd like to make to the council. One is that as of the end of this year, the $85 per month fee is ceased forever. The money taken into the account at that time will be capped with no future fees to be charged. Based on some of the other comments that came in, this will be a separate item at a future meeting. We are going to look at our MU zoning and possibly make changes and look at for more clarity and to make sure that it works the way it's intended to work. But my recommendation is that we cease the $85 a month forever as of the end of this year, and that we cap this, the amount of money that's in escrow, and we just cap that and leave it alone until it's time to use that money for repairs in their subdivision.
Okay. Recommendation is the $85 a month will be terminated December 31st.
Yes, sir.
It will be capped. The money that's taken in will be capped for that development on, for that subdivision.
Yes.
And it will be earmarked in an account for that one on.
Future repairs, yes. Designated for Marketplace Commons only.
And that one is. Then the ordinance that you have discussed will be looked at
at a future date.
Land use plan.
That's right. We need to look at some, and that came out of comprehensive plan sessions earlier this year. There's a number of changes we need to look at making to the MU zoning. That needs to be a separate item, and we'll address that in the future. This pertains just to marketplace comments.
I might also add that, taking into consideration, this was a pilot program. We had nothing else in the city coming like this when it was adopted. So I think this is fair for everybody in this development. And every development will be looked at as it on its own individual basis. And I think we figured that this development had 5,300 feet of road in it. And on an equal basis, if we have another development comes in under the MU zoning, you're looking at similar based on what we've done to this will be done and also with other developments. But that'll be looked at as individual as you recommend.
Yes, sir.
Okay, have a motion to that effect. Have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? Please vote. Unanimous. Thank y'all. Thank you. Meetings with the presidents of Marketplace, and I've enjoyed talking and working with you, and hopefully we have maybe marked a relationship that we can continue for a long, long time. Also, in meeting with the presidents at Marketplace Commons, the second item under old business is Curb Recycling. That was brought up here in the discussion. I know some of you may have received in your, if you received a utility bill of water or sewer, you may have received a questionnaire like this. And this is something that hopefully we'll be able to adopt at our next meeting based on the response of the questionnaire. We want to see the response from all of the water and sewer users and the residents of Cumming who are engaged in regular weekly garbage pickup. And this will be something that we hope we can adopt at our next meeting, but we gotta get the questionnaire back where we'll know the standards. So hopefully we'll be able to resolve that. In the meantime, anybody that recycles and wants to use the recycler, if they want to take, rather than having a curbside on the interim basis, you can get recycle at Todd Street Recycle Station here in Cumming, and it won't cost anything if you want to deliver it. But the curbside will be it will be on the agenda for our next meeting in November, and hopefully we'll be able to resolve that issue. And this will be something that's brought about by the being able to talk to residents, and especially the new residents. We've had a trial run on this several years ago, and it just faded out because people started mixing it all together and didn't want to recycle anymore. So hopefully we can have something to go on by the questionnaire that was sent out. Every utility user of water and sewer will be getting one of these if you hadn't already got it. So again, thank y'all for your participation. We appreciate the support. Okay, item three is postponed. We go to new business under seven. Item seven, which in administration we have Dr. Bonita Jacobs and Ben Jarrard, I believe, here tonight with us, Dr. Jacobs.
Thank you, Mayor. I think many of you probably remember that in 2012, we opened what was then Pilgrim Mills Center with about 200 students. And I'm here to announce tonight that we have over 1,000 students, undergraduate students now, at the University of North Georgia on the Cumming campus. I will tell you that this is phenomenal growth, and this equates to between 18 and 30% growth each year. And I had the privilege earlier in my career to help begin minor role helping to begin a campus in Dallas, Texas. Dallas is a little bit bigger than Cumming, and it took us 8 to 10 years to reach the 1,000 student mark. So that tells you what phenomenal growth this has been. But even more importantly, we're having students to come back and students who are continuing when they have a choice to go elsewhere. We're working on our long-range plan, and we're adding more graduate programs over here, and we'll be adding more baccalaureate programs, so stay tuned. But I want to emphasize tonight that this campus would have never happened without the vision and foresight of Mayor Ford Gravitt with the support of City Council. It would not have happened. He single-handedly brought this forward, and there was resistance, and he persevered. You know how stubborn he could be. And he persevered, and we collectively owe him a huge debt of gratitude. Thank you. Gifts in a moment, but I want to just run through a couple of things with you before I turn away from the microphone. We have since added a fifth campus in Blue Ridge, so we have campuses in Dahlonega, Gainesville, Watkinsville, Cumming, and Blue Ridge. We continue to recruit top quality students. As you know, the best predictor for success in college is how well the students did in high school. We're always number three behind Georgia Tech and Georgia in public institutions in the state of Georgia. So we're very pleased at the quality of students and they are performing. We were named for the second year in a row to Forbes Top Colleges. Last year was our first year. There were six public institutions in Georgia named. We were number four on the list, Georgia Tech, Georgia, Georgia State, North Georgia, followed by Georgia Southern and Kennesaw. This year we're named again. There are only five on the list. We're number three behind Georgia Tech and Georgia, North Georgia, University of North Georgia. So we're very pleased at how well our students are performing. We're one of only three public best value universities in Georgia named by Kiplinger. Best value means that the students get jobs and good jobs when they graduate for the amount of money that they pay up front. So it's not the cheapest, it's with the best value for it. And then I'm very excited that we are a top producer of Fulbright Awards. This year we have 9 Fulbright students, which will put us probably within the top 1, 2, or 3 in the nation of other than research one institutions. Last year, the top performer was Villanova. They had 11. Here's the difference. They had 120 applications for their 11. We had 14 applications for our 9 students. And then finally, this past week, I was able to attend the Association of the United States Army, where we were awarding the number one ROTC program in the nation and in the country. Underscore the importance of this vision that Mayor Ford Gravitt had with support of the City Council. And we have that we would like tonight to present the Community Partner Award. It says Community Partner Award presented to Mayor Ford Gravitt and the Cumming City Council in recognition and grateful appreciation of distinguished service and commitment to education, October 2017, University of North Georgia.
I
And Justin Pruitt, of course, runs our campus here and has views for our council. And of course, they all have University of North Georgia written all over everything. It's a little propaganda. But thank you all very much for your support of our campus and of our students. And those of you who are parents or friends, family of these students, thank you. Thank you for supporting our students. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Jackson. Quite a surprise, Tom. On behalf of the City Council, thank you so much for you as president of the university and your staff. What a great job y'all do. As y'all probably know, whenever we were discussing campus here in Cumming, Georgia for higher education, we had several people jockeying to be here. And we know it wasn't a hard choice to take North Georgia. And we're so proud we did, and we was glad that we were able to be a partner in a facility over here in Aquatic Circle. And we look forward to doubling the size of it, because with the growth that we're having, I know we're going to need it. So thank y'all very much.
I really must add that Mary Helen Magruder is with us tonight, and she's chair of our UNG Foundation, and we owe her as well. Thank you.
Moving right along here, we have, as council knows, staff has been working on our budget, and we have, as usual, this time of year, we try to help employees with the cost of living that's continuously rising. About every week you go to the grocery store, all of you know, I do my grocery shopping. I check prices pretty close, and it seems like every time I go to the store, the prices has increased, and sometimes a lot. So, in working on the budget, the staff is recommending to do the same thing that we did last year, and this time they recommended a 4% cost of living. Right now, and starting January the 1st, another 4% cost of living, and the insurance is going up 3%, so and recommending that we take that take into consideration also, and that money is provided for in the budget, providing the council approves the budget at our next meeting. So that's the request that I bring before the board now on behalf of the employees of the City of Cumming.
I make a motion that we go forward with the raises for the employees.
A motion from Woods. I have a second. Any other discussion? Please vote. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, under planning and zoning, we have alcohol license renewal. John?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, ladies and gentlemen of the council. You'll notice attachment A. The renewal letter that's in your packet. These are our businesses that have submitted their renewals to us along with all the fees and have completed all the required background checks. We do have two businesses missing off that list that are late, but they will be getting them to us, so we'll have to pay a little bit of penalty and we'll see them hopefully next month at the council meeting for their renewals. But this is the totality minus those two of the alcohol license businesses in the city.
Okay. Under counselor, can we adopt all these in one stroke rather than going through them individually?
Mr. Mayor, you can adopt all the renewals. I was discussing with Mr. Kaufman earlier. When you get to the transfers, I want you to vote on each of the transfers individually, but for the renewals,
attachment A is renewals only.
Yes, sir.
Correct. I'll make a motion that we approve all the renewals presented in attachment A.
Sure. I have a motion and have a second. In discussion. Please vote. Thank you very much. Okay, we have the transfer of ownership, and the first one would be Mr. Kaufman.
Yes, the first one is for the business of Beverage World on the ferry route there. DNC 44 Incorporated and Mr. James Chris
for, he's the new owner of that business and purchased it. He has completed all his background check, paid all the applicable fees, and is requesting that the mayor council approve his ownership and taking over that alcohol license.
A quick question there, if you don't mind. Do the new folks, when they do the background check, do any other jurisdictional alcohol violations show up on that? Where if they're the named licensee, got a violation somewhere else, that would show up so we would know?
Yes, sir. The background check that is done is a fingerprint background check. It's a more extensive background check than, say, for employment at an alcohol establishment, and that's done down at the police department, and it's a national background check using the fingerprints that are sent to them. So any violation in the jurisdiction will show up.
Okay, I have a request for
It was a beverage world.
Okay. Have a motion. Have a second. Any discussion? Ready to vote?
The next business, Mr. Mayor, is El Mescal Mexican Grill. We're taking over the old Laguna Grill right up here on the West Courthouse Square. Mr. Gilio Onegas is the owner of El Mescal, and he also has completed the change of ownership application as well as the fees and background check associated with that.
Okay, the Mexican Grill. Have a motion. Member accept the recommendation. Mr. Conklin, have a second.
Second.
Any discussion? Please vote.
Okay. The third one is from Mr. Giovanni, who has applied for change of ownership for the business of Osaka Katana.
Phase two is to be located from Sony Drive down to the Drive along the Gap Road. We advertised for bids for this project and received 7 bids, and they were completely close to the good bids. The lowest bid was from John D. Stevens, an amount of $2,786,421.00. The highest bid came from Mid-South Builders, $3,309,438. between those two, and we recommend going with a low bid from John D. Steve. We've worked with this contractor before. They're one of the top-notch contractors. They actually work with DMP quite extensively. They do a good job along the road, managing traffic control and things of that nature. So we're very pleased that John D. Steve is close to the lowest. And we do highly recommend that we accept this lowest bid from that contractor.
Okay, this was at seven bidders, and I think this was budgeted in our budget for this year.
We're planning a quite extensive next year too, phase three. So this has been something we missed in plan for a couple of years.
All right, we have seven bids, and it's about a little over half a million dollars from the high bid to the low bid. Had seven bidders, so it looks like we had some good participation from the contractors here on this. So what's pleasure to vote?
I'll make a motion that we accept the low bid from John D. Stevens.
A motion to accept the low bid from John D. Stevens Incorporated. Have a second. Any discussion? Please vote. Thanks. Okay, under announcements, we have upcoming playhouse shows. We have Fiddler on the Roof, October the 19th to November the 5th at 8 p.m. on Thursdays, and Saturdays, 3 p.m. Sundays at 3 p.m. Santa's Family Christmas, November the 24th, December the 10th at 8 p.m., Thursday and Fridays at 3 p.m., and at 8 p.m. Saturday. 3 p.m. Sundays. So Christmas shows at the Playhouse is great. We have been to see them. They have a great show. All the shows going on there. Also, the upcoming events at the Fairground with South County Sheriff's Office, Trunk or Treat event will be taking place October the 21st at 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. And also the upcoming events will be a fast-paced race for prostate cancer awareness October the 28th and 29th. That concludes the agenda. We have anything that's come to the floor? If not, I hear motion to adjourn.
So moved.
We have a second. All in favor? Thank you very much. Thank y'all for coming.
I hope so.
And what are those dates, October 19th, 20th?
He's like me, he's a little bit overweight too.
Y'all have individual service, have a dumpster.
No, we have trash cans in back of the park. They actually come around to the back.
Yeah.
They have picked those up for us because it's snow. So I didn't know.
How you doing, young man?
Could I ask about that?
Yes, sir.
To make sure they would just, you know, pick it up.
If you would, come up to City Hall, if you'll come right here. I'll be glad to meet with you.
You can go.
You can go. You don't have to wait for
it. It's fine.
Oh, it's from 8 to 5.
I appreciate it, sir.
Come up here. I'll be glad.
Okay.
If you don't see me, see Phil Higgins.
Higgins?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Was this the Marcus Mashburn?
Let's see, that's what I'm saying. Is it this Mashburn or that?
I don't know, because this year it will be 41 years old.